back, Davido has been dragged to an Igbo Shere magistrate court over an alleged fraud of 4 million naira. According to what they're saying, he was supposed to be on a song with an upcoming artist. The upcoming artist is said to be based in America, and he has not showed up for this, and he's not responding, he's not ready to pay back the money. And I think they've gotten like 2 court dates, and neither himself and his PA, I think, have not showed up. So I think the only place for them to now come up is social media to say this is what is happening. I don't know, but what do you think?
Okay, so this is I think this is like the second case against Davido about something like this, about taking money. And
No. This is the first one. The other one we discussed was for, what's this guy from Port Harcourt?
Duncan Mighty.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, true that. So so on this one, I think it's right. See, if you actually took money from somebody to be on their project and then you're not appearing, it's only right for them to take. And I like the fact that Nigeria is now going in the direction of, oh, we're no longer doing the internet trolls, we're no longer getting physical, we're no longer, you know, people are now beginning to think about the legal system, that we have a functional legal system that we can always lean back on.
Well, is this functional now?
Well, at least some people were getting justice here. Yeah, it may not be an equal ratio, but at least to an extent, we know that at least people now know their rights. I know the next step to take about certain things now. So if you took 4,000, but
$4 million.
Oh, 4 million naira. Huh. Wow, just for a feature. Wow.
Are you trying to change your career right now?
Are you joking? Just for a feature, $4 million.
You know?
Just to come and, for him to come and do, kill a commie. Funny.
But anyway, I have a question for you, actually, because you understand that space
legal
better than
practice.
I do. Yeah. So you talked about having faith in the legal system to be able to go forward. And as far as I'm concerned, these people, they must have lost their faith, because right now I've lost every faith, Seth. If somebody's supposed to come to the court first and they show up, second and they show up, what's supposed to happen?
Now, this is why it has gone public, because right now they try their best.
No, sorry, not even on their own part, on the part of the court of law. What are they supposed to do?
A bench warrant can be issued. The
so
third
why
time.
Has that
yeah.
not been done?
Yeah, probably after the third strike, and like we all know, probably out after the third strike, and then then a bench warrant, and anywhere Davido can be performing anywhere, and they will just arrest him. Do you understand? That's what a bench warrant is. So if he fails to appear in court, and now that this has gone public, I'm sure he's going to address it, and basically, what happens in most of cases like this is that they settle out of court. And this guy, you can also tell that, man, this one is so willing to settle out of court.
Oh, he wants his money.
But he's asking for 15% on the principal money.
Still fair.
So that's 4 million times 15% of the money. And for the amount of time it has spanned by, that's from January 2019, this is July.
Do you understand?
So for every month it goes on, that's 15% on every month.
Until it is finally liquidated.
Yeah.
So.
But yeah, he deserves
it's too
it.
Fair.
Yes.
Probably you'll be getting like 20 million by the time this is done.
How do I pay you for a project? You don't show up, you don't come, you don't return my calls. Okay, I take my thing
I'm
to
a
the.
Busy man.
Wow. But you are not busy to collect
the money. I'm just joking. But at the end of the day, I want us to also consider the fact that most of these artists that deal with agencies, that deal with management companies, that deal with a lot of that, and a lot of them do not even do their proper research to know your schedule. A lot of them just tell you that, oh, no, but this. But you know that these artists, they have a calendar. In fact, at the end of every year, you see all of them saying 2019 bag secured already.
Are you making excuses? That's what you're doing.
At the back of one, you're saying, oh, he shouldn't have done it. At the back of one, you're saying, but you know that
he's busy.
No, I'm not. That me saying he's busy is a joke, but maybe you went right over your head.
You've joked a lot on this show.
So maybe that went right over your head.
Oh,
like
you are just a bad comedian. Maybe
that's why I'm not a comedian and more of a serious person. Mm. So at the end of the day, what I'm trying to say is that we also have to look at the agencies, the management companies that work with these people that do not, because I don't think a Davido would be the one checking his calendar. Mm. So if his PA, obviously, if PA is so it's only right for you to drag a Davido, which is the person you want to feature and not his PA. But the person who could have made that deal could have been his PA,
most likely,
who didn't just do his research
right.
Yeah, so anyway, at the end of the day, I'm not making excuses, but I'm saying that we also have to look at it from both sides.
You want to say something?
No, mine is there's a 15% principal sum. So, I mean, every month, Davido, take till next year so that when you pay the money, the guy is rich. He's already secured the bag for 2020. So, that's mine.
All right. That's-